students, happy Sunday. Miss Emily here. Today's Bible story is about Jesus and his encounter with the Samaritan woman. Today we will be in John chapter 4. So I'll give you a minute to get out your Bibles and we'll turn to John chapter 4. You can pause the video if you'd like. All right, let's get started. Jesus had been traveling in the land of Judea. When it was time to leave, Jesus and his disciples traveled toward the land of Galilee. They traveled right through a place called Samaria. Now, he stopped at one of the towns where there was a well. So a well is this big structure in the ground, and inside of it and way down below is a bunch of water. So wells, they hold water, mostly drinking water. Jesus stayed at the well, and his disciples went into the town to buy food. A woman who lived in Samaria came to the well to get water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." The woman was very surprised. You know, Jesus was a Jew, and Jews did not like the Samaritans. You see, there was a long conflict between the Jews, the Jewish people, and the Samaritans. The Samaritans still believed in God, but they had a couple other practices that weren't quite the same as the Jews. So they really didn't get along. So she was shocked when Jesus came to speak to her, since she was a Samaritan and he was a Jew. "Why are you talking to me?" she asked. "I am a Samaritan." Jesus said, "If you knew who I am, you would have asked me for a drink. I would give you living water." Living water? The woman was very confused. Jesus did not have any water with him. He did not even have a bucket to get water out of the well. The woman asked, "Sir, where do you get living water?" Well, Jesus said, "Anyone who drinks the water from this well will be thirsty again, but anyone who drinks the water I give will never get thirsty again." That sounded wonderful, but Jesus wasn't talking about actual water. He was talking about God's Spirit. Whoever has God's Spirit will have eternal life. So basically, Jesus was using the water as a symbol for God's Spirit and giving eternal life to people who believed and worshiped in God and his Spirit. The water represented eternal life. So the water is just water, but it's a symbol. It stands for something. So the woman did not understand. "Sir, I want living water," she said. "Then I will not have to keep coming to this well to get water with my bucket." "Go get your husband," Jesus said. And the woman replied, "I do not have a husband." Well, Jesus knew that she was telling the truth. Jesus knew everything about this woman. Jesus knows everything about all of us in our lives. The woman could tell Jesus was wise. So she asked him a question about worshiping God. Then she said, "I know the Messiah is coming. He will explain everything to us." And you know what Jesus said? He said, "I am the Messiah." The woman left and told the people in her town what had happened. Many people believed in Jesus because of what the woman said. Jesus stayed in the town for 2 more days, and many more people believed in him. The people said, "We have heard for ourselves and know that this is really the Savior of the world." So Jesus, you know, is different from other people. He's different from you and I and everyone. Jesus loves everyone. Jesus did not care that this woman was a Samaritan. He loved her for who she was, just as he loved everyone, no matter if they were a Jew or a Samaritan. He came to give people a free gift, salvation from sin. When we trust in Jesus, we worship him as our Lord and Savior. When we drink the water that he has given to us, we are accepting God's Spirit and the gift of eternal life. Jesus died on the cross to save us from our sins, so we would not perish and we would not die without him anymore. We would go on to live in heaven and live forever in eternal life with Jesus. And that, my friends, is today's story about Jesus and his encounter with the Samaritan woman. See you next week.